Hello everyone, very good morning to all of you students. Welcome to the session of Building Construction Technology. So now students, till now we were discussing about the module which was related to building components, right? We are done with different types of building components which were important to us according to your syllabus. We discussed about 5 different types of building components. I think you are aware of all the technical parts and technical terms, also the sketches by now. I also would like to suggest that the sketches are very much important regarding your building component module. Now today we are going to move with the new module, new topic itself, that is special works and special treatment. Now, apart from the regular processes, apart from the regular construction work which is conventionally carried out, what are the other special things which have to be provided during your construction, right? So that will be related to special works and special treatment. It means that when you are carrying out the excavation work for foundation trenches, right? It is a normal work, normal procedure for any kind of construction. But now, if you are going for deep excavation, if the soil is of such type that it will get eroded or it will fall off from into the trenches, which is endangering the safety of your workers, then in that cases you will have to provide some temporary supports to the sides of the trenches, so that until the excavation work is carried out, the situation remains safe. That will be regarded as a special work because you are providing some kind of support. Likewise, if we have coffer dams, that is one type of deep foundation itself, but it is a special work. Then we have diaphragm wall construction. You know that commonly these days basement is how important. So for that, first of all, diaphragm wall is constructed, and this has become a huge trend in today's construction market. It is being constructed everywhere. About special treatment means your dam proofing course, first of all. It is one kind of special treatment, you can say that. Then you have thermal insulation, you have fire resistance, you have acoustical treatment, right? All of these things will be discussed in the special works and special treatment. So now, today we are starting with the first type of special work, which is known as temporary works. Now, you know what is a temporary work? We have studied that already in the formwork and centering, if you remember. Those are also one type of temporary structures, but they are the conventional type. They have to be compulsorily provided for the construction of any structural member. Now, we have special kind of some temporary works. What are those? As you can see, as you can read over here, we have scaffolding, we have shoring, we have underpinning, and fourth we have is timbering in trenches, right? About timbering in trenches, I already gave you idea right now. So we have 4 different types of temporary works, which are your special works, which have to be discussed. Okay, now we are going to start first with the timbering in trenches. As I said, whenever you are carrying out the excavation work for a foundation trench, right, the excavation work would be progressing down vertically, correct? Now the sides of the trenches, if that soil is unstable, it is going to get displaced and it will fall into the trenches. Now if it happens at a very big level, or if the depth of excavation, the workers have gone down far enough, and if the soil, the surrounding soil, the sides of the trenches get displaced and get failed and fall in the trenches, then it will be a big disaster. So what will you do over here? So as your construction is progressing, as your trenches are being excavated for the foundation, you will provide them temporary supports in the form of vertical rafters, horizontal wales, right? You can provide timber planks, timber sheets. So we will make different kinds of arrangement for providing this temporary support, so that up to which the excavation is carried out, till then it will keep your surrounding sides of the trenches safe. Did you understand what is timbering in trenches? Okay, now we are going to further discuss. Okay, let me show you an image. Look at the image flashing above me. I think what I explained right now, right, the words which I said right now is giving meaning to this image. Can you see how the foundation trenches excavation is carried out? You can see the temporary supports for resisting the sides of the trenches is provided. You can see that. Yes. Okay. This is known as timbering in trenches. It means that you are providing temporary timber work, wooden rafter, wooden plank, wooden board. We will call it as struts, wales, rafters. We have different names for different horizontal and vertical and diagonal parts. And this type of temporary work is known as timbering in trenches. Okay. So where do we use this? Okay, it says when the depth of excavation is exceeding 1.5 meter. And if your soil is soft soil, cohesive soil, loose soil, right, in such cases, this type of temporary support has to be used. Look at the second image flashing above me. One more example of your timbering in trenches. Okay, so what are the types? What are the types? According to the depth of excavation, we have different types of arrangement of your temporary structures. We have box sheeting, we have stay bracing, we have vertical sheeting, we have runner system and pile system. About the pile system, it is nothing but your sheet piles. As you know, we have already studied about the sheet piles. So that is also included in this type of timbering of trenches. Now, again, looking at the animated picture, can you see that a box-like structure is formed? We have lots of vertical planks which are spaced closely to each other. They are connected with horizontal members and a box-like structure is formed, right? This supports your foundation trenches. So this type is known as, what is it known as? It is known as box sheeting. Now I am going to discuss all of them in detail. Okay, starting with the first one. First, what do we have? Stay bracing. See, we have just given names to it. Otherwise, only the arrangement is going to change. Otherwise, it is all the same. Only the names are differing. And also, the depth of excavation will also differ, right? So, first we have is stay bracing. Now, look at the image flashing here, the sketch which is drawn. You are also supposed to draw the sketch if this is asked. What do we have? We have the vertical boards, right? Vertical boards which are attached to the sides of the trenches. Now, as you can see, they are not closely spaced to each other, right? They have certain distance between them. Okay, now the vertical boards will be called as sheathing boards, right? Or poling boards. Just giving names, nothing else, students. So the vertical members will be called sheathing boards. Next, we have those boards on the two sides are connected with horizontal members. Now, horizontal members will be called as struts. Did you understand the arrangement? So, this type of timbering in trench, when you are providing this type of temporary support, when the depth of excavation is not going to exceed 2 meters, at that time, you can use this type of temporary work known as stay bracing. Look at the second image. What can we see over there? We can see that two horizontal struts are connected for one sheathing board. You can provide that additional support can be provided. If the width of the trench is more, you can do that. Moving to the second one, we have box sheeting. I already told you, what was the difference between box sheeting and stay bracing? Yes, I think with the help of the sketch, you will be able to make out, right? What do we have? We have the vertical sheathing boards, we have the poling boards, but they are very much closely spaced to each other, right? Not like stay bracing, they were spaced apart. Here, it is just like a full sheet. If you look at from far, it appears like it is a full sheet. Okay, so different vertical boards are closely spaced to each other and then your horizontal struts are connected such that it makes like box like a structure is known as box sheeting. Okay, now in the box sheeting we will have two different types. We will have vertical, we will have horizontal. Now the sheathing boards or the poling boards, if they are placed horizontally and then your struts are connected, which you can see in the image also. From the image itself, you can see the difference between these two, right? So, if that kind of arrangement is provided, then it is known as horizontal sheeting. Okay, this makes your box sheeting. You can go through the technical dimensions which you are supposed to remember. About the depth of excavation, if it does not exceed 4 meter, stay bracing was up to 2 meter and this is up to 4 meter. This type of timbering in trench is used. Next, what do we have? Third, we have runner system. See, I am not discussing vertical sheeting over here because it is the same as the box sheeting. The only difference is as the excavation work progresses, they are going to install step by step your vertical sheeting boards. Now, in the runner system, what do we have? Look at the sketch flashing over here. What can you see in the sketch? We can see that as the excavation is progressing, step by step, your vertical sheets or vertical boards are being placed. But you can also see that a steel shoe is fitted at the bottom. The cutting edge, right? You remember about the pile shoe? Yes. The same kind of shoe is attached at the bottom so that it can be fixed easily into the ground. You can drive it easily. They are driven directly into the ground. And runner system means it is a progressive system. As your depth of excavation increases, as you move more and more, this system is simultaneously inserted and this makes your runner system. Okay, so now we are moving to the next type of temporary work. We discussed timbering in trenches at first. Now we are discussing the second type. Second type is scaffolding. Now see students, scaffolding and shoring, both of these things you have seen in your routine life to a very great extent. Everywhere you have seen this type of arrangement. Can you see the image flashing above me? Yes, you can see that such kind of arrangement is seen by you extensively at lots of places you have seen. Right? We are just giving them names, we are just giving them technical words and we are understanding the concept that why this kind of temporary work has to be provided. Now, what is scaffolding? Look at the image. Scaffolding is a temporary structure, right? When your structure, when your construction is under progress, you have seen that such type of temporary structure made up of bamboo, made up of timber is arranged outside, just external of the building. You have seen that. You can also use timber rafters or steel rafters. It is being used currently extensively. So the temporary structure which is provided, right? When the height of the wall, or the other structural member is more than 1.5 meter. So let me say, if I want to carry out the paint work outside, if I want to carry out the plastering work outside, if I want to do the pointing work outside and the height is more, the worker is not going to reach up to there. So for that purpose, obviously we will need scaffolding so that the external work, it can be carried out. So it is made up of timber planks, as I said, and it is erected close to the work so that you can fulfill all the finishing purposes, your decoration purposes or your repairing work also. Sometimes if you want to repair it, sometimes if you want to replace the part of a building, rebuild the part of a building, then also you can use. Okay students, now what are the types of scaffolding? Okay, before moving to the types of scaffolding, let us discuss about the components. Now, basically, your scaffolding is made up of vertical members, horizontal members, transverse members. On top of that will be your plank boards where the worker can stand and do the work, right? Let us give them a name. First, the vertical members, right, which are attached to the ground are known as standards. Next, Horizontal members connecting your vertical members, ledgers. Next, the transverse members, right? The transverse members, longitudinal members are known as putlocks. Next, we have braces, the cross braces, the diagonal braces, right? With the standards and ledgers, the box which is formed. If you provide diagonal braces, then those are called cross braces. Next, we have transoms. Transoms are those materials in which putlock will be having one end into the wall of the structure and one end on your scaffolding work, right? Now, if The transverse member is provided such that both of its ends are resting on your ledgers itself, which will make your one type of scaffolding, which we will discuss in detail also, then it is known as transverse. About boarding, as I told you, for the workers to stand on, we have to provide boards. Those are known as planking boards. Okay, you can see diagonal braces also in this image. I am showing you another example how it looks. I think this is very much common to you. Now we are discussing the types of scaffolding. Okay, how many types do we have? First, we have bricklayer scaffolding or single scaffolding. Second, we have mason scaffolding or double scaffolding. The image which is flashing right now is an example of double scaffolding. It means it will have transverse, right? None of the part will be resting, none of the part will be fit into the wall. It will be separate and you can move it anywhere and erect it near the building and carry out the work. Next we have is cantilever. Cantilever or needle scaffolding. Look at the second image flashing over here. Can you see how it appears? We have a cantilever beam. It may be a terrace, it may be a roof, it may be a balcony, or sometimes the area is such that it is a busy area and you cannot erect the scaffolding just from the ground level. And in those cases, you can provide this type of scaffolding known as needle scaffolding. Next, look at the image, suspended scaffolding. Can you see the suspended? It is suspended with the help of ropes. Generally for cleaning purpose also suspended scaffolding is used apart from coloring work and painting and finishing works. Next we have steel scaffolding. So instead of timber rafters we will use steel. And the last we have, the image which is flashing over here is your trestle centering. Okay, not centering, it is scaffolding. Do you remember trestle centering? We have discussed that, right? Truss like structure is formed with the help of these temporary members, that is your trestle scaffolding. Now let me show you in detail about the different types of scaffolding. First we are going to discuss about the bricklayer scaffolding or single scaffolding. Now look at the sketch, look at the drawing which is over here. What can you see in that? We have the vertical members, standards. We have horizontal members, ledgers. Then we have the transverse members called putlocks. We have the cross diagonal. Those are known as braces. I think everything is included over here. Now what happens over here is the putlocks, they will have one end fixed into the wall with the wall plates. And one end will be resting on the ledgers. On top of that will come your plank board on which the worker can stand and perform the work. Now, where is this used? This is generally used for brick masonry construction, because in that to fix the members it becomes easy, right? In stone it becomes difficult, so you cannot use this type of scaffolding over there. So it is generally used for brick masonry work. Okay, look at it for the real, how it appears, how the brick masonry construction, in that how this type of scaffolding is placed so that you can carry out the finishing works. Okay, next we are moving to the second type, that is your double scaffolding. Did I mention already that there will be sometimes putlocks which will have both ends resting on ledgers. It will not be fixed to the wall. Those are called transverse, correct? You can see that over here. I think I showed you a real image also in the previous slide. So in stone masonry construction, when it is not possible to insert the putlocks inside the wall, then such type of scaffolding can be used. Okay, this is called double scaffolding. Now moving forward to the third type, will be needle scaffolding, also known as cantilever scaffolding, which I already told you that if the street is busy, if you cannot provide the members directly from the ground, if it is also a cantilever or any kind of such beam or a terrace or a roof, then such kind of scaffolding can be provided. Now, what do you need to understand about this? We have two types. We have single, we have double. So the the struts which are provided, the diagonal struts which are provided, may be either fixed to the wall or it will be taken inside of the wall and it will be fixed to the floor, right? It depends on your span, and according to that, two different type of arrangement can be provided. Next, students are going to discuss about the another type of temporary work known as shoring. Now, why is shoring provided? Shoring means it is a type of temporary support which is provided when your structure becomes unstable, when your structure becomes unsafe, or it is already leaning. So, to stop it further from leaning and carry out the repair work, till then you can provide temporary support in the form of vertical, horizontal and diagonal braces made up of timber in most cases is known as shoring. So, difference between scaffolding and shoring. Scaffolding is provided basically for the external works. Shoring is provided when you want to provide safety to the building which is already about to collapse, or it is weak, or also if you want to remove the part and construct a new one. Okay, so let us discuss about shoring. We have three different types. We have raking shores, we have flying shores, and we have dead shores. Now, raking shores are diagonal shores. Okay, all of three are different types, but they are basically diagonal, vertical and horizontal. So for the raking shores, what do we have? You can see that a wall is supported with the diagonal braces. Those are known as rakers. This type of arrangement which you can see over here is your raking shores. Okay, now the diagonal braces, right, which are provided as a temporary support to the wall. The wall may be unstable, it may be unsafe, it may be leaning, or it may be, have to be reconstructed after demolition. Then this type of shoring can be used. Okay, now the diagonal braces are called rakers. Its angle, the outermost raker should have angle of around 60 to 75 degrees, not more than that. If there are more rakers provided according to the floor, right, then you will have to tie them up with braces so that it gives more stability. And also these rakers are fixed into the ground with the help of plates. Those are known as wedges or stakes or dogs, right? Such kind of arrangement is known as raking shores. Next we have flying shores. Now, when we are dealing with two walls, when you are dealing with two walls, right, you have to support two adjacent buildings. In that case, what you will do, you will connect both of them with a horizontal strut. You will provide diagonal struts for more support. You will also provide a straining sill or a straining beam so that all the load coming from the diagonal brace will be transferred to the sill and it will keep your structure stable. This type of horizontal arrangement is known as flying shores. Okay, so in flying shores again we will have two different types. We will have single frame, we will have double frame. Obviously, when the span between two adjacent wall increases, you will have to provide double frame, otherwise you will provide single frame. Have a look at the double frame also. What can you see? That here two flying shores are provided. They are connected by vertical struts. Again, they are connected by diagonal braces. It is just a game of geometry, nothing else, right? This type of shoring makes your flying shores. Next, we have the third type is dead shores. Now, if we have discussed the diagonal ones, if we have discussed the horizontal ones, then these are going to be the vertical ones, right? When you want to let us say that remove the part of the floor or the roof, or if the roof has become unstable that it can collapse anytime, so where you provide the vertical support between the two floors with the help of introducing a horizontal member called needle, then this type of shoring is known as dead shores. These are basically your vertical shores. So you can make out the difference between these three, that when and where this type of shoring can be used. discussing last about the method underpinning. What is underpinning, students? Now, if I say I have an existing foundation, correct? It is shallow foundation, correct? Now the foundation has become weak, right? By providing certain tests, we found out that your foundation has become weak. Now, you can do two things. Either you can repair the foundation or you can remove the part of foundation and replace it. That is retrofitting. But how do you carry out this process in an existing structure without disturbing the stability of your existing structure? Then we have two methods in which you can strengthen the existing foundation, or you can replace the foundation, or you can convert the shallow foundation into deep foundation. That process is known as underpinning. This is specifically done for your improvement of the existing foundation. You can provide two methods. We have a pit method, we have pile method. What is a pit method? You can see the image over here. Look at the first image on the left flashing. Can you see a pit is constructed around your foundation? Yes, a pit has to be excavated around your foundation. You will have to hold your structure with the help of hydraulic jack, and the repairing work is carried out and it will keep your existing structure stable. Second method is pile method. In this, you can directly insert the pile members. Can you see in the second image? You can see that pile members are directly inserted. The structure is held with the help of hydraulic jack, and then your repairing work around your existing foundation can be carried out. So this is known as pile method. Okay, we have two methods, pit method and pile method. Okay students, this covers your full topic of temporary works in the special work category. In the next session, we shall discuss about more. Let us call it a day now. Thank you.